Today we have another project. This is EOS, and at the end of this video I will give you price prediction for EOS, so as I will tell you what I think about Bitcoin, where we are moving. First we will talk about EOS and what is going on with EOS. As you can see, currently it's ranked 16, top 16 cryptocurrencies. And what is going on with EOS? Why all cryptocurrencies are moving up and EOS is moving back down? And I also have in this video one bad news in regards to EOS, and if you are already in EOS and you are in EOS community, you probably know this news. But if you are just as investor watching this video, you might not see this news because it happened just recently. EOS is another smart contract blockchain technology. As in previous video, we already reviewed, as you remember, Polkadot, we already reviewed other ones, we reviewed Ethereum, and in this video we are going to review EOS. And EOS is one of the biggest cryptocurrency blockchains, and this is one of those projects which in ICO stage, which is actually famous for this, because on ICO stage it collected 3 or 4 billion, I'm not exactly sure about number, but those were billions which they collected in ICO stage, guys. So this project has a lot of money to go with. EOS is coin. This is not Ethereum token. They have their own explorers. An explorer is the front-facing face of blockchain, or people can see what is going on blockchain. And that's why blockchains have explorers, guys. As some of you have been asking me, what is explorer and why it's needed, guys. So Ethereum blockchain technology has an Etherscan block explorer. Bitcoin blockchain technology also has a Bitcoin blockchain explorer, which is created by blockchain.com. If you are not aware, then you can go to blockchain.com and you can see a lot of information. This is just front-end representation what is happening on blockchain. However, it is just reading data from blockchain and nothing else. It can't affect blockchain itself. EOS also has a coin because they have built their own blockchain and they have their own blockchain explorers in circulating supply. Currently out there are 939 million, and total supply is also 1,026,000,000. One thing about EOS is that it is inflationary. Every single year 5% of EOS are being generated, and 20% of these 5% are getting dedicated to staking, but we will talk about staking a little bit later in this video. Now let's go into EOS.io, which is their official website, and here are their features. EOS is built for businesses, so as for private developers, and everyone can come in and start using EOS blockchain technology. And one thing about EOS blockchain is, and this is like their specific thing which no other blockchains are using out there pretty much, which is that they are storing data off chain, which means that their data is not being stored on blockchain itself. For example, if you think about Bitcoin, then Bitcoin all transactions or history about transactions and everything is being recorded, and it is being stored on blockchain in blocks, guys. So one of the main things about EOS blockchain technology is scalability. As you can see here, that is scalable, and the target of scalability was 1 million transactions per second. Obviously that is not reached yet. However, their transactions are very fast. Another thing is that this blockchain technology is very easy to use for developers. And on EOS blockchain technology, there is also staking, there is delegated proof of stake, and this delegated proof of stake has 24 nodes. And anyone who wants to stake, for example, if you have EOS tokens, you can stake and you can vote on these delegators. You can choose which delegator you would want to vote for, and one EOS coin is counted as one vote. The more coins you have, the more votes you have in particular delegator, if you are voting for some delegator, guys. I will not be getting into too technical details, but all these delegators are block producers. So main thing about EOS, what you need to know, like I mentioned, it is that they are storing that off chain. It is easy to use and it has a huge community, and as far as I know, they have the most dApps built out there, guys. So this is one of the most used blockchain out there. But there is also bad news about EOS, and this is about Dan Larimer. Dan Larimer announces departure from EOS pool builder Block.one, as Block.one is company which is building EOS technology. And Dan Larmer on 30th of December in 2020, a couple of days back, as you can see updated on January 11th, he left Block One, and he is the main EOS developer. And not to mention, guys, that Dan Larmer also has left BitShares before. There was another blockchain he was working on, and Steemit. So as well, we are talking about Dan Larmer, and this is also the developer who invented, or who pretty much created, delegated proof of stake. So yes, guys, this is very smart guy, but as you can see, he is leaving these blockchains and leaving them like pretty much alone. And I remember when he left Steemit, and Steemit pretty much also died because he left it, because lots of people lost like kind of hope in Steemit. And it was also rather interesting blockchain. I was using it myself, I was posting, I had my account, I have even now somewhere my account there. But Steemit was also good blockchain technology. Yes, and then Larmer decided to leave it, and as you can see, he's saying, I will continue on my mission to create free market voluntary solutions for securing liberty, property. And this is one of his kind of sayings where he's saying all the time, I do not know exactly what is next, guys. But in general, I don't think that many people will trust his next project or whatever he will be doing, because he already let down three projects. This is just to my opinion. And that's, to my opinion, is this factor why this coin is not going so fast. It's not growing so fast. However, to my opinion, EOS is a rather strong project, guys. It has a huge community, it has a lots of developers, it has a huge company, Block One, which stands behind EOS. And I believe that anyway, this project has a future. However, this year we also have to think about other blockchain platforms, like for example, Ethereum 2.0 is coming out. And also, we don't need to forget about that there is Polkadot, which I also reviewed in my previous video, as you remember. This is also one of competitors for this blockchain technology. And then we also have to remember about Cardano, which is also saying that they, this year in 2021, they are coming out with their smart contracts. And if they come with much better projects, for example, Cardano comes with their much better project, and if Ethereum 2.0 comes with much better project, these two giants have also a huge amount of people and huge communities. And in any blockchain, the main thing for any blockchain or any blockchain project is its community, guys. And that could be a huge threat for EOS. And we will live and we will see what will happen. But for now, I think that EOS price haven't gone up only because Dan Larmer left Block One recently, in pretty much 1st of January or 30th of December, guys. But however, I think its price will go up, because most people are here on blockchain for speculation, and EOS already have a huge community. EOS has already a lots of developers, and there will be new people coming in. So I believe that this year, when altcoin season will come approximately in 4 or 5 months, this price could easily go to $10. And this is just my prediction. And now let's get into Bitcoin price. We can clearly see that Bitcoin is still bearish, and I would be very careful currently with Bitcoin, because I think that it can still go very bearish. Because currently, if you look at technical data, you can clearly see that this is bearish. This is not a bullish sign what Bitcoin is doing. For example, if we currently we are looking at 4-hour chart, we can see W pattern here, which didn't work out, because normally this pattern should break this neckline. And it didn't break that neckline, but it went down, as you can see. Instead, it started going down. However, it can still do this. It can still do this with confirmation. And with confirmation, what I mean, I will show you just now, guys. What I mean is, if this pattern will go like this, if we are looking at daily chart, if we go into 1 day chart, just by looking what price action is drawing us here, and what is indicators like MACD indicator, what is telling us, as you can see, MACD is currently bearish. It has broken down, and this is on daily. And if something on daily is happening, we should be very careful about it, because if on daily MACD has broken down, this is very strong indicators that we might go down. And like I always was telling you guys already before, I think that we are still, this pullback is still hasn't finished, but we will see what is going to happen. But to my opinion, we will be going still down, and this is not the first attempt, and we are still not going up. So as for market in general, for the market power, and so we get Bitcoin price higher, we need a bigger pullback currently. This pullback which happened right now, it is too small. And here as well, as you can see, we had this higher high, and currently price is clearly turning back down. And if it will not break with this previous high, guys, this means that currently we are very bearish, and we will be bullish only in that scenario when this previous high will be broken. And if we start breaking down, for example, if we break these previous lows, we could go even lower, and we could go, like I mentioned, my price target was 25,500. So yes guys, this was my video on EOS, and if you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you are new, and see you in the next one.